Greetings. I wanted to make a video about the topic of Mohammed in Deuteronomy 18 because he is often claimed to be mentioned in this scripture by those who follow Mohammed. But let's take a careful look at what Deuteronomy 18 says. The verse that is often referred to is Deuteronomy 18:18. I will raise them up a prophet from among their brethren, like unto thee, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. Now, if you've been taught to see this verse, you've been taught to see the word Muhammad right there. And you've been taught to see the word Ishmael right there. Does that make it clear? This is the way the verse actually looks, and that's the way you've been taught to see it. So the real question is, does brethren mean Ishmael? Let's look at the word brethren. Deuteronomy 18, verse 1 and 2. The priests, the Levites, and all the tribe of Levi shall have no part nor inheritance with Israel. They shall eat the offerings of the Lord made by fire and his inheritance. Therefore they shall have no inheritance among their brethren. So in the verse 1 it says, they shall have no part nor inheritance with Israel. And in the next verse it says, they shall have no inheritance among their brethren. We see in verses 1 and 2, brethren means Israel. In Deuteronomy 18, verse 6 and 7, if a Levite come from any of thy gates out of all Israel, where he sojourned or traveled, and come with all his desire of his mind unto the place which the Lord shall choose, then he shall minister in the name of the Lord his God, as all his brethren the Levites do. So here we see all his brethren. Whose brethren? The brethren of the Levite. Who is the brethren of the Levite? The Levites, the other members of the family of the tribe of Levites. We see in verse 7, brethren means the Levites, which is a subgroup within Israel. So it is still meaning Israel for brethren. In Deuteronomy 18:15, the Lord thy God will raise up unto thee a prophet from the midst of thee, of thy brethren, like unto me, unto him you shall hearken. A prophet. Could this be Muhammad? Of thy brethren. Could this mean Ishmael? This is an exact parallel of Deuteronomy 18:18. There's a key phrase here, from the midst of thee. And what does from the midst of mean? Well, it means from the middle of, from within, or from the inside. From the middle of what? Of thee. What does thee mean? Who is God speaking to? He's speaking to Israel. He said, I will raise up unto thee a prophet. So what does unto thee mean? It means the prophet is going to be sent unto Israel. Jesus said, I am not sent, but unto the house of the lost sheep of Israel. Jesus was very clear. His mission as a prophet was specifically to Israel. Muhammad, on the other hand, never once set foot inside Israel. He didn't go to Jerusalem that anyone can document. He didn't go anywhere into Israel. He did not speak Hebrew. He was not sent unto Israel. So in verse 15, we can again see that brethren means from Israel. So here are the two verses, Deuteronomy 18:18 and 18:15. Moses is speaking and he says, "The Lord thy God." In 18:18, God says, "I will raise them up." "Unto thee, I will raise them up a prophet." "From the midst of thee," Moses said, "from among." "Of thy brethren," "their brethren." So if you look at it, both verses say that God will raise them up, meaning raise up for Israel. "Shall speak unto them," means speak unto Israel. "Among their brethren," means from Israel, or from the descendants of Isaac, from the Jewish people, from the Hebrews. It is not possible that this is from Ishmael. These all mean one thing. This verse does not speak of Muhammad. So is Muhammad mentioned in Deuteronomy 18:18? No, he is not. It is that clear, it is that simple. Any attempts to try and claim Muhammad is mentioned in 18:18 is done in disrespect of the Word of God, is done in disrespect of the prophet Moses and what he said, and is done in disrespect of the living God and what he said in Deuteronomy 18:18. But why? Why is it important to find Muhammad referenced in the Bible? Because it is obvious that Jehovah, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, is the one true living God. This is where Muhammad has attempted to establish all his credentials. If you sincerely respect God, if you say you are submitted to God, then you need to respect God's word. And you need to show your respect by honoring God's word. Don't just say it with your mouth, but honor God with your heart and with your thinking process. Is Muhammad in Deuteronomy 18? Is he? Go ahead and ask yourself that. No, no, no. Muhammad is not possible as an explanation or fulfillment of the prophecies of Deuteronomy 18. He simply does not meet the text of the prophecy. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.